this is the continuation of part 1 pasty video. Due to poor video quality, my video was suddenly stopped. Whenever I just started four-fold rolling and folding technique. Already I discussed about three-fold and book fold or double turn rolling and folding technique. Now I will discuss about the four-fold technique. So the dough is now rolled into this type of sheet, 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. And all are equal divisions. So four-fold technique is something like that. That is part one or first part that is on my right hand. That is first part on the second part. Second and first part is now jointly make a part. And this is now going to the third part. And this first part, second part and third part make a common dough. And this dough is now, this common three doughs is now placed on the fourth part. So that is called the four-fold technique. Generally, if you number of turns or number of folds you increased, then actually the dough must be very, the selection of the flower must be hard type. So whenever your flower is hard wheat, then you will select four fold folding technique. Now come to the methods of making the puff pasty. There are actually three methods. First one is French method. Second one is English method and third one is Scotch method. I will directly go to the French method. You write down, in French method, step one is that select 80% of the total flower and 10% of the total fat. That means if your total weight of the flower is 1 kg, then you select 800 gram, and if it is flour and fat ratio is 1:1, you select fat 1000 gram and you take 10% of that is 100 gram. So ultimately you take 800 gram of the flour and 100 gram of the fat and knead the flour with cold water. Already I told you why cold water is used in part 1. Salt solution means salt with added water. Lemon juice or cream of tartar or vinegar with 10% fat with low speed. Because why low speed? Because if high speed is applied, then the fats are oozing on the top of the surface. That is not acceptable. So at the low speed RPM, the gluten development will be happened. And when your dough is smooth and the elastic and good consistency dough, you stop your mixing and make this dough make this dough like round figure. Make this loop dough like round figure. This is like round figure. You understand? Make this dough like round figure. So this round ball dough now placed into the refrigerator where the temperature inside the refrigerator is 6 degree to 10 degree centigrade temperature. And place this dough for half an hour inside the chilling condition, 6 to 10 degree centigrade temperature. Next, step 3, make the batter block or square. That is remaining 90% butter Now make a block like this, square type of block, like this. Make a butter block. Cream this butter and add 20% of the remaining flour into the cream butter. Make into a square block and kept in the refrigerator for the setting. So what is step 3? That is the 90% fat and 10% flour, now 20% flour, now mixed well and make a block. Make a block and keep this block. This block is like this. Make a block and keep this block inside the refrigerator at the same temperature, 8 degree to 10 degree centigrade. Now after that, you collect the dough, that is the already it is round made dough. Collect the dough, and this dough, already you know that this dough is like round shaped, round ball, and you eliminate these portions from the dough. This is round dough you collected from the refrigerator, and you collect by eliminated the hatch line, the hatch portion from this round dough. That is, you cut down like this. So this amount of the dough, this amount of the dough, this amount of hatched dough, this amount of the hatch dough, you eliminated. So what is the figure of this dough? The figure of this dough is now like this. You understand? Figure of this dough is now like this. So that is the figure. You eliminate the excess dough like hatch line. You eliminate it. So whenever you eliminate it, the excess dough, your dough is this. Your dough is star-shaped. It is looking like star-shaped. After that, you rolled the dough such like that, you make into a square shape. That means this star-like dough now convert into the star-like dough. You understand? This is now by the rolling action, you can transfer this star to plus sign of dough, or this type of dough. These are called the flaps. These all four corners are called the flaps. Generally, the thickness of the corner should be 1/4 of the thickness of the center. So this is the thickness of the center. The thickness of the corner is 1/4 of the center thickness of the center. That is, it is more thick, it is less thin, it is less thin, it is less thin, it is less thin. So this is thick. So if you observe, this thick portion also a square shaped. You understand? This thick portion also square shaped. The total is dough. Total plus sign is dough. Now already your refrigerated condition of the step 3, that is the fat plus flour block, square block, is now refrigerated for 30 minutes or the 1 hour. That block is now placed here. That block is now placed here. You understand? That square fat plus flour, that is 90% fat plus 20% flour block, which is already refrigerated, it is now placed here at this center. This square shaped portion, it is placed. Now you cover this fat flour block, most of the fat portion, by these four flaps like this. This is flap 1, this is flap 2, covered it there. This is flap 2 covered, the flap 3 covered there, flap 4 covered there. So ultimately you make like this. Whenever you cover this, you get like this. You get ultimately like this, because the center is already square in shape. So ultimately whenever you added the all the four flaps onto the center, you make this type of square shaped block. So this refrigerated block, block, square shaped block, now you place into the refrigerator for 30 minutes with covered with a damp cloth or the plastic film. This block is now covered with a damp cloth. What is damp cloth? That is means the wet cloth and the plastic film. You covered and put into the refrigerator at the same temperature, 6 to 10 degree centigrade, for 30 minutes. Now you collect this block again from the refrigerator after 30 minutes. You now roll the dough like a rectangle. This dough is square shaped. Now it is moved to this rectangle. So whenever it makes into rectangle, it's looking like this. Whenever the square shaped dough, whenever the square shaped dough is rolled, it is looking like this. So that is the length of the dough. Now you divided this dough into the three equal portion, 1, 2, and 3. Three equal portion, first portion, second portion, and the third portion, and apply the threefold folding technique. Already I told you in part one, that is the what is threefold. That is the fold 1 to fold 2 to fold 1 plus 2 is fold 3, like that. So you apply this technique and again you make a common block, common square block. So this square block is again you refrigerated for 30 minutes with the covering of damp cloth or the plastic film, and that block is again rolling into this type. Again you do this, make into three equal portions and apply the threefold action, threefold folding action, and this can be repeated for thrice or twice, twice or thrice you repeated this technique. That is block to rectangle, rectangle to threefold, threefold to square block, square block to refrigerated, refrigerated to again the rectangle, rectangle to threefold, threefold to square block. This type of making you apply for at least 2 to 3 times. So after that you now make into the final sheet, you now make into the final sheet like that. So finally sheet the dough and pinned by the dockers, that is this dough is now make some holes by the docking actions. This dough is now pinned by the docking action and cut into desired shapes. Why docking actions? Because during baking what happens, there are so many layers already formed, so these layers can be lifted due to the action of the water vapor. So wherever dough is lifted, this water vapor can be ejected. If not ejected, the dough must be burst. So to avoid this, we must to make some holes on the top of the pastry dough sheet and cut into desired shapes and give rest for half an hour. That is relaxation time. Give rest for the half an hour and then baking at 220 to 235 degree centigrade temperature. So this is the general procedure for the preparation of the puff pastry by using French method. During baking, you always remember that the fat present in the layers melts and creates gaps between the sheets of the dough. Because you know the fats, lot of fats are there. One, if it is 1:1 ratio of fat, then the fats are more. So they are melted inside the baking oven. The fat present in the layers melts and creates gaps between the sheets of the dough. Whenever, suppose this is your dough sheet. Whenever the fat melts, the gap between the successive two sheets are increased. So, the gaps between the sheets of the dough. Next one, the dough sheets start to harden and maintain their shape as the gluten present in them coagulates and holds the shape. Ultimately, the dough sheets hardens, because the dough sheet means what? Starch or the protein molecules. So, starch molecules are cooked, the protein molecules are denatured. So, naturally, ultimately, the dough sheets become hardened and maintain their shape as to the gluten present in them coagulates and holds the shape. Finally, we become a good type of shape. As the heating continues, the liquid in the dough turns to steam. As the heating continues, the vapor, water vapor forms, and this steam actually raises the successive two layers. So this fat dough, this fat melts. Whenever fat melts, the gap between the successive dough, this is dough, in between the fat melts, then the whenever fat melts, the distance between the dough increases. You understand? But gap between the dough creates. So, due to the generation of steam and the melting of the dough gap is created, which pushes the sheets of the dough apart and pushes them upwards. And that is why lifting to be happened. Whenever the gaps increases, the lifting to be happened, and lifting is such like that the volume of the final dough must be 10 times as compared with the initial volume. If the initial height is something like this, then the final volume is 10 times, that is this. So your pulp volume is increased. So these are the changes occurs during the baking, that is very important at 220 degree centigrade temperature, 220 to 235 degree centigrade temperature, this happens. Next one is English method. You write down the difference in the French and the English method is essentially in the rolling of the dough. The making of the dough is same as the first step of the French method. That is, in French method, we make the dough. How we make the dough in the French method, first step? That is the 80% of the flour, 10% of the fat with salt solution, with fat, with acid, etc., etc., salt, sugar, etc. You make a dough. But this time you cannot make a dough ball. In the French method, you made a dough ball like this. But here you not made a dough ball. Rather, you made a dough sheet. Rather, you made a dough sheet of rectangle size. Like this. Made a dough sheet like this. So, now, press and roll the dough to a rectangle which is almost 2/3 and 1/3 divisions. It is something like that. 2/3 and 1/3 means it is like this. That is, you make, this is 2/3, this is 1/3, 1/3, 1/3, this is 2/3 and this is 1/3. So you make the dough like a rectangle shape, 2/3 and 1/3, 2/3, 1/3, and refrigerated this dough for 1/2 hour. Understand? And similar like French method, you made a fat paste or fat dough. That is the 90% fat plus 20% flour, you made a dough. and this is refrigerated for 30 minutes. This dough is made for refrigerated for 30 minutes. Now this butter block, after 30 minutes you collect the butter block, after 30 minutes you collect the rectangle sheet you already refrigerated. Now put the butter block in these two positions. Put the butter block into these two positions. Butter block here, one third, and one third butter block is here. And this dough is here in the dough, the butter block is absent. So here the butter block is absent, here the butter block is present, here the butter block is present. So two third portion is the fill of butter block, and one third portion is free of dough. Next, you now put this non-butter block dough on this. You understand? This is non-butter block. Now you put this non-butter block on this one third butter block. So ultimately you get, this is butter block, this is butter block plus non-butter block. So you get the ultimately this block and this block. This is 1 plus 2, this is 3. So after that you cover this fat block on this. You understand? You cover this fat block on this and make a square type of shape. And again you rolled the dough, and again you rolled the dough, and again you rolled the dough like rectangle shape, and make into a threefold axon. And this threefold axon now put into the refrigerator for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes you collect, you again make a threefold like sheet, and again you threefold, and again rectangle, and again this square shaped block put into the refrigerator. This step also you repeated for 30 minutes, and after 30 minutes you raise this dough for the relaxation and then baking at the same temperature, that is 235 degree centigrade temperature. So basically the difference between French method and the English method is not so much, just the rolling action, folding action, difference is there. Otherwise, the French method and the English method are almost same. French method and English method are almost same. So next we go to the Scotch method. There is some difference between the French method and the Scotch method. Already I told you, in French method the mixing are divided into two steps. Okay. But here the mixing action is one step, but this is partly divided into two, that is, number one is like your pie dough preparation. Can you memorize that pie dough preparation? The flour fat mixing. The fat particles are solid, the flour particles are mixed, it is heterogeneous, so mixing will be very carefully done. So like this, this type of mixing is required for this Scotch method of preparation of the puff pastry. So here after the flour and the fat is mixed, then you add the water like pie dough making, and this water and the other ingredients whenever you add it, then the dough is slightly wet. To avoid this wet nature you have to add some dusting flour on this sheet. Similar like pie dough, you have add some dusting flour because your rolling will not be proper. So if your rolling will not be proper, your molding or the folding will not be proper. So to avoid this, or since the dough is very wet, we have to inject some dusting flour on the sheet. So more amount of the dusting flour is required for the Scotch method as compared with the French method. So in French method, the puff pastry is more soft, and in Scotch method, the puff pastry is not so much soft. It is rather called, it is hard. So this puff pastry is quite hard as compared with the French method puff pastry preparation. So after the dough making, the dough will be covered with a damp cloth or say polyfilm like that. Why? Because previously I not told why the damp cloth. Because to avoid the dryness of the dough, because you observe in refrigerator also the dryness happens. The drying happens inside the refrigerator. If you keep some amount of the milk or some amount of the soup inside the refrigerator, after some days you found your milk volume is decreased or the soup volume is decreased. Why it happens? It is a very amazing, because in refrigerator also some evaporation taking place, the evaporation of the milk or evaporation of the soup taking place. So to avoid the dryness of the dough, we can cover the dough by the wet cloth or the polyfilm. Basically the wet cloth is more acceptable, and cool it for the, or refrigerate it for half an hour, same temperature, 6 to 8 degree centigrade temperature. Seat the dough into square shape. You understand? Like book fold type. Seat the dough into a square shape. This is square shape. After that, bring the two edges of the center and again fold over. Like your book fold. It is book fold. So, this book fold is applied here. That is, first you made a square shape. This shape and then this shape. Now you place and make a common square. So this type of book fold technique is applied for the folding technique. Rolling and the folding technique, the book fold is applied. So this will repeat it for, that is, book fold, square shaped. Again it is refrigerated for 30 minutes. Again you do this same technique. This is repeatedly for 2 to 3 times. After that, you cut the desired shape. You make a sheet. This is the rectangle sheet. Cut the desired shape. And again you darkening and make some holes, or make some holes to escape the moisture or the liquid water vapor from the dough. So cut into the desired shape and the rest before baking at the same temperature, 220 degree centigrade to 235 degree centigrade temperature. So this is all about of the three methods of the preparation of the puff pastry: French method, English method, and the Scotch method. Out of this, which method is more applied? French method is more applied because this method, the pastry product is very soft. Puff pastry will be very soft. So that is why French method is mostly applied. Next, Danish pastry. This is different kind of pastry. This is not called as a puff pastry. This is, its own name is Danish pastry. So what is Danish pastry? It is a sweet yeast dough. Here the dough is actually fermented. In the previous puff pastry, in all the methods we observed, we found that there is no fermentation taking place. But in Danish pastry preparation, the fermentation step can be applied. So it is a sweetish dough laminated with fat and cut into different shapes and used chocolate, cheese or any sweet filling. The ingredients required for the Danish pastry preparation: flour, obviously strong flour because the fermentation taking place, sugar, yeast or Saccharomyces cerevisia, fat, mainly the hard type of flat fat is used, water, that is chilled water is used. Why chilled water? I told earlier. Procedure: you write down, weigh the ingredients correctly, weigh all the ingredients correctly, add all the ingredients and mix well, allow for fermentation for 6 to 8 hours. Because this is a fermented dough, fermented pastry. So naturally, Danish pastry is fermented pastry. You have to ferment this dough for 6 to 8 hours. Give rest for 20 minutes for dough relaxation. Because you know, need the dough relaxation. Why? You know. If you want to know, you go to my bread lecture. Bread video lecture in YouTube. Seed the dough into square shape and apply the fat and fold like French method. So your folding will like French method. So French method is what? I again repeat, how the in French method the folding will be happened, but we done. That is, we make the seed into the three equal portions, and this is one foldings, or it is called the two folding, and this is three folding. So this rectangle now put into refrigerate, and after some time, 30 minutes, again you do this like that, rolling by this, and make a fold, 1, 2, 3, that is 3 fold. You repeat this 2 to 3 step, that is the, you follow the French method. After finishing all the foldings procedures, seed the pastry and cut into desired sizes and bake into desired shapes. Place the pastry on a greased tray 2 inches apart for the expansion. Give egg wash and proof until double in size or it is very light to touch. So you grease the dough or the pastry dough by the egg washing. Why? Because for the glazing purpose. Not only the glazing purpose, it also have some enrichment of the protein. Whenever you wash the protein egg on the pastry dough, then that is the addition of the protein. So this is non-vegetarian pastry. Previous three methods of the pastry preparation, they are all veg pastry. Bake at 175 degree centigrade temperature to 200 degree centigrade for about 10 to 15 minutes. After baking is happened, give sugar syrup. Washing, sugar syrup concentration is 50% or 50 degree bakes for shining and the softness. So after the baking, you wash the baked puff by 50% sugar syrup or 50 degree thick sugar syrup for shining and the softness of the product. And for all the cases, I not mentioned earlier that is the some terms are very, very important for the pastry making. Now, what is makeup for the pastry preparation? You write down, makeup is, sometimes we may follow that we refrigerate the dough, we refrigerate the fat, we refrigerate the fat flour mixture, some this type of rectangle size dough we also refrigerated. So that refrigeration technique is under the makeup. And sometimes we make the dough sheet. Sometimes we make the dough sheet, that is also under the makeup section. And sometimes we make a dough sheet of particular thickness, that is also called makeup section. Sometimes we relax the dough. Before baking you followed, we relax the dough. So that is also under the makeup section. So whenever you asked what is makeup for the pastry preparation, you may write the makeup for the pastry preparation is that whenever we done refrigeration for the dough or the dough sheet, refrigeration for the dough fat, square shaped or rectangle shaped sheet, that is makeup. Whenever we make a particular thickness of dough, that is makeup. Whenever we relax the dough before the baking, that is also makeup, under the makeup section. What is rolling? Rolling is something like that. Your dough is say this. So you now make into this dough into this sheet. How you do this? By the rolling action. So that is the rolling section. Always you remember, during rolling section, the rollers must contain some pins. The rollers must contain some pins. Why the rollers contain pins? Because the rollers actually can spread the fat onto the dough evenly. Spread the fat onto the dough, onto the dough surface, but on the dough surface evenly. Then that is why the rolling must contain some pins, some small pins like that. So this is the rolling section. And sometimes we washed the dough. Sometimes we wash the dough before rolling or after rolling. That is not mandatory, but sometimes we found that washing is also happened. Washing by either by the sugar syrup, either by the melted fat, or either by the butter, or either by the egg wash. So this washing also to be done before or after rolling. And leavening. Leavening is something like that. That is the whenever your product is lifted. So in which section the product is lifted? That is during baking, your product is lifted. So that is called the leavening of the product. So already I mentioned the spring of the oven or the oven spring happened during the leavening of the dough. Why leavening happens? Because this is your dough. So whenever the moisture or the water inside is evaporated, and this evaporated water now passes through the small holes. So whenever this water evaporates through the small holes and ejected through the holes, then the dough is lifted. So that is why it is called the leavening step, and that is done inside the baking oven at 200 degree centigrade, sometimes 220, sometimes 235 degree centigrade, like that. And one term is important. Already I told you oven spring in class, that what is oven spring. The proper oven spring must be happened. So cool oven, what is cool oven? It is not acceptable. If your baking temperature is less, then that is called the cool oven or cold oven. If it is happens, then your volume of the product will be low, poor volume, and your product will be dry. So if your oven will be cool, that is below the your desired set temperature, then these two factors will come, that is not acceptable, poor volume and the product must be dry. Hot oven is that when the oven temperature is high as your set temperature. Whenever your oven temperature is say 250 degree centigrade, your set temperature is other. But you set the oven temperature at 250 degree centigrade, then the oven is hot. So it is also not acceptable. On that condition, the product will crack, the volume will be uneven, and the product is not soft, or rather it is hard. So you have to keep in mind these two parameters, these three sections: makeup plant, rolling section or rolling plant, and the leavening section of the leavening plant, it is nothing but the baking action. After the pastry preparation, like all the pastry baking, like all the bakery products baking, the cooling is mandatory. So you have to cool this pastry at the normal temperature or maybe some chilled air flowing, and after that you keep this pastry, either you packaging or you not packaging, you put this packaged or unpackaged pastry inside the refrigerator at 1 degree centigrade to 3.3 degree centigrade. That's this refrigerator temperature is to be maintained. At this temperature, your product is stored up to 10 days maximum. So the shelf life of the pastry is only 10 days at this temperature. So you may write down the difference between the French method and the Scottish method. You listen carefully. That is the French method and the Scottish method. What is the difference between French method and the English method? You write down. These are very important. They will come in class test or semester. So you follow my lecture carefully and then you write the differences between them. Now the common faults, the last part, that is the common faults of the pastry making. Number one fault you write down, fat comes out during sitting. During sitting, fat comes down during sitting. That means that your fat melting point is very low. Your fat is not hard. Your fat is not refrigerated. What is the reason? Your fat comes down during the sitting. That means that your fat melting temperature is not high, fat is not refrigerated, your fat quality is not good. So number one or two, three points. Next point is that dough will be too hard. If the dough will be too hard, then the fat can be melted. Too much of the dough temperature. If the dough temperature is more, I already told you that dough must be prepared by the addition of the chilled water. If your dough temperature is high, the fat must be melted from this seat. The fat must be melted from this seat. Uneven rolling and the folding. I mentioned there is some technique of the folding like this. I mentioned there is some technique of this folding. You folded like this. Haphazardly as per your wish, like that. This is folding. So uneven folding or unscientific folding may hamper your product quality, and ultimately your fats comes out from the product before baking or during baking, more fat will be come out. So that is very important. Too high fermentation temperature. If your product is fermented like Danish pastry, then if your fermentation temperature is high, the fat must be comes out. Next one, fat runs out. Next problem, fat runs out of dough while baking. The point is that whenever fat comes out during the baking, your turn will be less. Suppose here required 4 turns. 1, 2, 3, 4, like 4 turns. So you apply here 2 turns. So whenever you apply 2 turns instead of the 4 turns, then the number of turns will be less, means the fats will come out from the dough during the baking. So that is the less turns. Number one point. Second point is that too high baking temperature. If your baking temperature is too high, then the fat will come out from the dough. If your baking temperature is too high, then the fat will come out from the dough during the baking. So this is problem number 2 and its 2 causes. Problem number 3, that is the your puff is rough and dry. So what is the cause or what are the causes of this problem? Number 1, too tight or the hard dough. Already I mentioned that if your flour is very, very hard, then your product will be chaff. So number one point. Number two is too less fat. If your fat is less, your product will be dry. In my part one lecture at the beginning section, I already told you that without the fat, any bakery product will be tough in texture, tough in quality. So too less fat is the culprit of the dryness of your puff pastry or any pastry. Too high oven temperature, if your oven temperature is already, just I told you, it is hot oven. If your oven is hot or commonly called hot oven, then your product is dry. Product will be dried. Last problem, that is too small and the too soft. Problem number four is that is the too small and the too soft. The reasons are, number one, you write down, too many turns have been given. If the too many turns have been given, then what happens? Then your product strength will be less. If your requirement 3 turns and you apply 6 turns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that. So what happens? Your product texture will be less. So it is soft in nature. Uneven cutting. Already I told in some method, French method or something like that. Or every method, that you cut the dough into your desirable shape. If your uneven cutting is there, then this problem will be happen. Underproofed for the too small. That is, underproofed means that if your fermentation time is less, that is called the underproofed. If it is underproofed, then this problem will be happen. This is for the Danish pastry. If it is overproofed, then that is too soft. If it is overproofed means over fermentation, if your fermentation time is more, then the product will be too soft, your volume will be increased. If your fermentation time will be more means that what? Your volume of the product will be increased, and if your volume will be increased, it is very very soft. So these are the common faults we found for the pastry making, and these are the reasons we found. So lastly, I sum up the discussions of part 1 and the part 2. That is, in part 1 I described the introduction part of pastry, ingredients required for the pastry, what are the reasons and the functions of the ingredients required for the pastry making, what are the types of the pastry. Generally pastry are two types. One is short pastry and another is puff pastry. Short pastry is quick making pastry, puff pastry is long making pastry, but the quality of the puff pastry is very very good. And after that, I will go the types of the pastry making according to the flour fat ratio. After that, I will go to the folding, rolling and the folding action of the dough sheet, that is the three-fold action, book fold and the four-fold action. Then methods by which we make the puff pastry, that is the French method, English method and the Scotch method. The three methods I elaborately discussed, and with some paper like diagram I discussed. After that, I go to the Danish pastry preparation. Danish pastry is fermented dough actually required for this type of pastry making. How this pastry is making, I elaborately discussed. After that, I go to some important terms like makeup section, rolling section, leavening section or baking section, and why these sections are very important for the pastry making. And last and not the least, the problems found during the pastry making any kind of pasty making, puff pasty making or the Danish pasty making. So I elaborately means four problems I discussed with their regions. So I think this is all about my lecture related on the pasty and its manufacture or and its making. So that is all over about the bakery products making, that is the biscuit making, bread making, cookie making, donut making, wafer making, pie making, and the last and not the least, pastry making. So I already elaborately discussed. If you have any doubt, you may ask. And this is the video number, video number 8. So 6 plus part 1 pastry, this is video number 8. So you follow all the videos, lectures properly, concentratedly, according to the Einstein's quote, that is, the concentration to learn is very, very important for the student's life. So you concentrate in each and every lecture, and if you have any doubt, you please ask me through mail or you directly call me to my mobile number. Already my mobile number is given to you. So next day or next lecture, video lecture, I will discuss about other topic, obviously related on the bakery topic, because the bakery is still now not completed. So I will continue the another interesting bakery topic, not the bakery product, because the bakery products are now completed. So you may follow the next video. So lastly, I may say that stay safe and must be present inside your home. Don't leave from your home, and I will come back in my next video lecture. Thank you.